Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I am going to explain you normalization of floating point number. See, in computer when we store numbers as per floating point numbers, there are two standards that we usually use. One is IEEE 754 single precision standard and second is IEEE 754 double precision standard. Now both of these standards are there as per floating point number representation, and that you can represent only if you have idea about how to normalize given floating point numbers. So let me explain you how to do that. So I'll explain you that by four simple problems that will give you idea about how exactly we can normalize any number, right? So here we are having first number, you see 01101, then dot, then 1011. Now when you want to normalize this, first of all you'll have to see what is the sign. Now you see sign is positive, right? Here I'm saying this sign is positive. Now once we have positive sign over here, what we need to do? We need to normalize this. Normalization means what? Normalization means you'll have to represent any number as per one point something. Remember this. Normalization means what? You'll have to represent number as per one point something. So you see, we are having 1101, then 1011, right? So let me write that first. 110, then 11011. Now fraction is over here, right? I need to place fraction over here. One point something means this is how we are normalizing it, right? Now, if you observe here, as I have normalized it by providing fraction here, by how many digits we have jumped? You see, we have jumped by 1, 2, 3. So, we have jumped by 3 digits over here. Means, you will have to multiply 2 to the power 3 over here, right? So, what it indicates? 2 to the power 3 means 3 is our exponent over here, right? So, here, my dear students, you see, this is sign, this is exponent, and after one point something, whatever we are having, that is our mantissa. So you see 1011011, that is our mantissa is there. But here, my dear students, we don't represent sign as per plus over here. In computer, you cannot store plus minus like this, right? So how to have sign over here? So for that, my dear students, what we need to do is, we need to have minus 1 to the power as a sign. Now minus 1 to the power 0 means it is positive over here. So you can say 0, that is what? Sign over here, right? So when you normalize any number, what you need to do? First of all, you'll have to represent sign. After that, one point something, that is how you'll have to represent the number. And then into 2 to the power, you'll have to write exponent. Let me give you some examples. So like in second question, what is that which we are having? You see, here we are having 1100111. That is how digits are there. And this is positive. So for positive, minus 1 to the power 0, that is my sign, into 11, you see that is how it is there. Then 00 and then 111 is there. So here I need to provide a fraction, one point something, that is how I need to convert that in normalized form, remember always. And if you observe, by how many digits we are jumping towards left side? By one digit, you see fraction is jumped over here by one digit. So into 2 to the power 1. So you can say this 0, that is my sign over here. This 1000111, that is my mantissa over here, and this one, that is my exponent over here, right? Now let us solve third question here. You see 0.0001011, that is how it is there. So this is positive number. So for positive number, minus 1 to the power 0, that is our sign that we represent here, into 1011, that is how it is there. So I can say 1.011, that is how I can represent this, and into 2 to the power exponent. You see now towards right side how many digits that we are shifting? 1, 2, 3, 4. So 2 to the power minus 4, that is what I need to write over here. So what I can say? This 0, that is my sine over here. This 0, double 1, that is my mantissa over here. And this minus 4, that is my exponent over here, right? That is how we can have normalization. Let us have one more question over here. So in fourth question, you see minus is there. So minus means minus 1 to the power 1, right? So here this 1, that explains what? Sine. Then into 1 point something that we need to represent. So 1 point, you see 1 point 101, then 0011, that is how it is there. Now by how many bits we are shifting towards left side? 1, 2, 3. So here 2 to the power 3, that is what I need to write. Right, so this 101, 0011, that is my mantissa over here. This is what? 2 to the power 3, where 3 is my exponent over here, right? So my dear students, this is what you should know when you have any floating point number representation. See, this is what we will be using it in that IEEE 754 format, right? So many of the times varieties of questions that may come. So for that, first of all, this basic understanding, that is highly essential, right? So what we need to do? First, we need to represent sine. That is what? Minus 1 to the power 0 or 1. Minus 1 to the power 0 means what? Given number that is positive. Minus 1 to the power 1, that is what? That means number is negative. That is the first thing. Then secondly, what we need to do? We need to write number as per 1 point something. That 1 point something is what? Mantissa, right? Now to have that, you may be shifting that fraction, means that decimal point, towards right side or towards left side. As if you shift it towards left side, in that case, you will have to multiply 2 to the power number of bits by which we are shifting towards left side. As if you shift that bit towards right side, then 2 to the power minus number of bits that we are shifting towards right side, right? And that is giving you exponent. So generally, when you store numbers which are there in floating point number representation inside computer, at that time we will be using IEEE 754 single precision and IEEE 754 double precision standards, right? I'll explain you both of those standards in next coming videos. Based on that, definitely there will be many questions that you will be solving in future. But before that, you should have this basic understanding. This is highly essential. This is the backbone of this floating point number representation. Still, if anything that you like to share it with me, please note it down in comment box. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.